there's talk of collaboration. Yes, there is collaboration in this revolution, but there's also immense competition. And the winner is the customer. We hope the customer experience with developments like today's improves tremendously, and the ease of making payments, the ease of saving, the ease of buying financial products increases tremendously. And of course, it's very important from our perspective as regulator that this come both with stability as well as safety for the system. Before I go into the meat of my talk, let me also emphasize, talked about sending payments, Mr. Tiwari talked about sending payments to rajan@unionbank.com. Let me emphasize that first, the Reserve Bank never sends out emails asking for payments. Never. We have about $360 billion worth of foreign exchange reserves, and we also have about 8 lakh crores of government bonds. We really don't need your money. So if you get an email from me saying you won a competition, or you won a lottery and I'm going to send you 50 lakhs, but please send 20,000 as transaction costs, just junk that email. We don't send out money, but we don't also ask for your money. Okay, so I get about 10 emails a day asking me if those requests are fake or real. They're all fake. But let me get to the meat of today's, why we are here today. We're here to celebrate an achievement. And I think it would be fair to say that much of this achievement comes from the vision of one man, Nandan Nilekani, who's been a great champion of technology, not just in the financial sector but elsewhere, but certainly has been pushing it in the financial sector. So my thanks to him for working on this selflessly, not just when he was at UID, but after that. Let me also thank Mr. Hota for pushing this and Mr. Balachandran for giving the vision. I should also not forget my colleagues in the RBI, namely Deputy Governor Khan, but also Mr. Padmanabhan, who's now retired, who was a vision behind payments. You need a visionary regulator to work with the visionary Nandan to make things actually happen, and I think our people have risen to the challenge. Mr. Chandan Sinha, who's not here, and of course Ms. Nanda Dave and her team in the payments department. So you've already heard what this does. Mobile to mobile, account to account, it's convenient, it's safe, we don't really exchange bank account details. It's on a need-to-know basis, much as in the intelligence system, the bank only gets to see what it needs to see. Customer details are not shared across the system. Of course, it helps in reducing the use of cash, and it also allows people to use remote bank accounts to make payments without necessarily going anywhere near there or near an ATM, which will be very useful for our remote villages. It allows for easy accounting and verifiability and facilitates over time credit flow based on generation of data, which is something that can be built on the system. As I said, interoperable from the beginning. This is unlike many payment systems across the world, which often are owned by one entity. This can be used by any entity, and that will be very important. Now, we've already talked about all the benefits. Let me talk about things we need to work on as we go through, some of which our colleague from SBI pointed out. We have made a tremendous leap in allowing this to be a competitive framework. where you could have up to seven players involved in the system, the customer, the merchant, their service providers, and their banks. These all could be separate people. There are six of them. And in addition, there is the seventh player, which is NPCI. So somewhere along this chain, transactions may go wrong. We hope very few, but they could go wrong. And so we have to work out how the system of dealing with customer complaints, grievance redressal, will actually take place, as well as how we will protect this system against security breaches, fraudulent transactions, etc. Now, this is something we have to work out as we go. It's not something we can anticipate fully. Some anticipation has been done, but as we go along, we'll have to figure out what the problems are and how we deal with it. Also, what is work in progress is enhancing this experience from those with smartphones to those who don't have smartphones, and enhancing it from just the banks who are part of the system right now to players outside the system and to other networks in the payment system. So there is some way to go, but this is a very important first step. I don't want to take too much of your time. You've listened to a lot of speakers, but let me end with what our view at the Reserve Bank is on the regulatory process. If I were to put it as simply as I can, it would be we attempt to be informed and adaptive regulators. What does that mean? It means we start first by understanding the problem, doing some careful analysis, helped, of course, by players who want to make change. So we work with the people who are being regulated on the regulatory architecture. And we hear them out. They give us a lot of proposals. We look at those proposals. But we look at them both from the perspective of the system, but also try to figure out the biases of those people making the proposals. What is in it for them? And how is it that it might affect the architecture of the proposal? We try to be open. We try not to limit too much where there's uncertainty. One of the dangers of being a regulator is the easiest thing to say is no. And so when there's uncertainty, when you don't understand how things are going to develop, it's easy to say no, let's not even go there. Problem, of course, is if you say no, you never work out what the problems could be. Maybe there are no problems, and you keep the system from developing. Too many limitations up front, and you prevent growth and development. So what we prefer, I would think, is to say, okay, let's watch it. Start, and as we understand it better, the regulation can evolve. And this is the adaptive process. We watch carefully as the instrument, the institution, or the process is rolled out. Look at where the grievances are coming from, where the conflicts are emerging, and what possible risks there could be, and thereby adapt regulation if necessary. Some examples of these in recent months, interest rate futures. Interest rate futures had been started before and died because there were too many limitations on them. We started them again a year and a half, 2 years ago, and now it's a flourishing market with tremendous amounts of volumes. And this is because, to some extent, industry persuaded us to be a little more open about what we allowed. There was innovation in the kind of product that was created, and this is now flourishing. One area which we made some changes based on recommendations of the Nachiket Moore Committee was to allow niche banks. Payment banks are one example. We have Paytm with a payment bank license. We're taking a bet on them. Paytm is, a very innovative firm.
Okay, Raghuram Rajan there, Governor RBI, talking about a banking revolution, talking about new banks coming in, new systems, new platforms, and challenges being the regulator in this dynamic space.